Holiness Sivarama Swami.
Video, I don't know, a few weeks back, Krishna-lila sent me a computer version. And of all the really wonderful aspects of it, two parts really stayed with me. One was a devotee in Brazil, Ramputra. I remember the name, I don't know him, but it was a striking name. And he said this very wonderful thing. He said, ISKCON saved me. And I think we can all agree to that, although sometimes it may appear that ISKCON's torturing us and bringing us to nervous breakdowns and other types of things. But that's not really ISKCON. ISKCON is perfect. Unfortunately, those of us who participate in it aren't necessarily so. And as a result of that, we, just like the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra is perfect, and it has unbelievable benefits, and yet we struggle to actually reap those benefits. Why? because of what we do to the Hare Krishna mantra or how we actually cover it up. And so ISKCON is also such a wonderful transcendental vehicle because ultimately it's a form of Srila Prabhupada and a form of Krishna. It's an extraordinary vehicle that's given us, it's given us life, given us hope, given us a future, and a real perspective of what reality is. I've been sort of associated directly and in the beginning indirectly with ISKCON coming on to almost 50 years. And we're moving on. Yesterday I went to visit Vajrahari Prabhu, who is in hospital. And the queue's getting shorter day by day. We're also coming to that stage where Krishna consciousness is going on to the second, third, fourth, fifth generation of devotees. We're, you could say, the first generation who came to serve Srila Prabhupada. So ultimately, it's in the hands of others. I see Kripamoya Prabhu here and Shakshi Gopal Prabhu. At least for myself, I can say this leg is already somewhere in, well, we use the word samadhi rather than grave. Anyway, we're moving on, and the second very poignant point is right at the end. Jai Sri Radhe, was that her name? That she didn't want Srila Prabhupada's mission to go in vain. And that's why we're here, whoever's here, we want to ensure that what Srila Prabhupada actually gave the world continues on in the same pristine way that Prabhupada gave it, the same philosophy, the same mantra, the same culture, the same lifestyle, dare I say the same appearance, the same dress, and everything else that comes along with the Krishna consciousness movement. It's no longer in our hands. It's in the hands of successive generations. And that was an extraordinary ending for me. Krishna-lila, if you're still there. And that's the real message that I think Srila Prabhupada really drove home to all of us, that we shouldn't let what Srila Prabhupada gave us go in vain, but rather from the other perspective, really make it happen in the way that Prabhupada wanted us to make it happen. He wanted us to grow. He wanted ISKCON to grow. I gave you the framework, now you fill it out. Prabhupada didn't want us to make him an Alexander, and he wanted us to take Krishna consciousness to every town and village, let everyone get the extraordinary benefit of what it means to chant Hare Krishna with love, and let ISKCON save them. Ultimately, let ISKCON save the world. That was Srila Prabhupada's vision. And that vision needs to be carried on. I can say it's, well, there's this very beautiful poem which was written by a soldier in the First World War. In Flanders fields the poppies grow, between the crosses row on row. I won't say the whole one. And then at the end he says, the torch be yours to hold it high. With us, I can't remember, unless I say the whole thing from beginning to end, and I don't want to bore you with that. Anyway, he's saying the same thing, that you hold up the torch, because in Flanders fields, they're already laying there. So we're not going to be in Flanders Fields, we're still not laying there. But ultimately, like the Olympic torch, it needs to be passed on generation to generation and really give light. Krishna Surya Samamaya Haya Andhakara. Really give the light of transcendental knowledge to others and let ISKCON and Srila Prabhupada do their magic, do their wonders. And something that I learned from one of my heroes in Krishna consciousness, his name is Harinamananda. He's a wonderful book distributor. Every once in a while when I pass through Switzerland, then I meet up with him. And one day, well, it wasn't just one day, but we were on, Kripamoy Prabhu was also there at that time, we were on Navadvip Parikrama. And he was also there. And that Christmas marathon, on one day, he distributed over 1,000 Mahabig books. You just figure that out in 12 hours, that's like 80 an hour. That's like more than one a minute, 1.5 books a minute. So I said, Harinam, how did you do that? And his answer to me was something which has always been very helpful in my Krishna consciousness. He said, well, I just tried not to get in the way. So same way, if we don't get in the way of the International Society for Krishna Consciousness, and we don't give each other headaches, then it will actually do the extraordinary wonders that Srila Prabhupada has empowered it to do, because Srila Prabhupada is there, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is there, our Guru Parampara is there. Just don't get in the way, and then everything will happen. Hare Krishna. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. ISKCON ki jai. Okay, Krishna-lila, my telephone's going down, so I'm going to let you go, okay? Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.